began as an experiment, the training of psychologists who are Christian in faith and practice. Many said that having a graduate school of psychology attached to a seminary would not work. A few believed it could work. This is their story. It all began in the late spring of 1961. John G. Finch had delivered three invited lectures to the seminary community, and a dream was born. The time was right. Fuller was ready. And the seed sown would take root. The vision was not just for a new program that would help pastors become better counselors, but for a whole new school to be added to the seminary. A graduate school of psychology to train mental health specialists to serve the church. Many were enthusiastic and contributed in kind and ideas to the birthing of the new school. Foremost were Davis and Annette Weyerhaeuser. Their son, William, was to become one of the early graduates of the new school. Every prominent psychologist who would listen was asked for his or her opinion. Carl Rogers, Rollo May, and Viktor Frankl, among others. But their voices were uniformly pessimistic. It couldn't be done, most of them said. The experiment would fail, they predicted. One of the key players was not pessimistic, however, and he would play a crucial role in the founding of the school. David Allen Hubbard, newly appointed to the presidency of the seminary, believed in the dream and gave it his wholehearted support. But what should come first, a clinic or a school? Well, for starters, there had to be a dedicated administrator who believed in the dream. Very early, the initials MF began to appear on minutes and letters. Marnie Fredrickson, better known as the beloved Marnie, was to become as crucial to the fulfillment of the dream as any faculty member. Next came the clinic. A few key faculty in the seminary who had backgrounds in psychology or marriage and family were borrowed from the School of Theology and joined by Adrian Silling and Donald Tweedy, who had been specifically recruited to be the nucleus of the new clinic. One of the distinguished faculty borrowed from theology was Robert Bauer, then professor of Christian education. Dr. Bauer would later go on to found the Marriage and Family program in the School of Theology. But from the birthing of the dream, the question that plagued everyone was, who could possibly be dean? Where could they find the right person to be the founding dean? In retrospect, it all seems so providential. Who can deny that Lee Edward Travis, already retired from a distinguished academic career in psychology and considered to be among the most frequently quoted psychologists in America, was God's chosen leader? The story of his conversion and call to Fuller is legend. Fuller's dream became his dream. But was he suited for a school? In a seminary setting. When President Hubbard approached a prestigious USC professor for a recommendation for Travis and confirmation that he could indeed serve in this unique capacity, the professor is purported to have replied, "I know who Travis is, but who is Fuller?" Lee, with Lisa by his side, would go on to serve as dean for the next 11 years and to teach until his death at the age of 92. One of the youthful faculty members that Lee Travis recruited was an MDiv graduate from Princeton and a PhD graduate in clinical psychology from the University of Chicago, Neil Clark Warren. Neil had written to Travis inquiring about a teaching opportunity in the new graduate school. But when he heard it was not accredited by the American Psychological Association, he got cold feet. An encounter with the seductive Travis did the trick, however, and Neil joined the other faculty that Travis had recruited, all relatively young. Paul Clement, James Oakland, and later, Newton Maloney. Little did Neil know that he would later become the faculty's choice to succeed Lee Travis as the second dean in 1975. For the 7 years of Dean Warren's leadership, significant progress was made on several fronts. The student body was enlarged, and new faculty were recruited, including Hendrika Vandekamp and Richard Gorsuch. Together with Newton, these three would all succeed to the presidency of Division 36 of the American Psychological Association. Dean Warren consolidated the clinics and placed Paul Clement, now a nationally distinguished leader in psychology, in charge of the newly configured Psychological Center, one of the first of its kind in the entire nation. Also under his leadership, the dream for a new and expanded building complex began to take shape. But at the end of the 1981-82 academic year, Neil decided to return to private practice, and the search for a new dean was begun. After a nationwide search, Archibald Hart became the third dean in 1982. The last of the faculty to be recruited by Travis, Arch had come from South Africa 12 years before to be a part of this faculty. Building on the foundation of Neil Warren, Dean Hart's first challenge was to complete the planning of the new building complex and move it to completion. At this time, another major event in the history of the school and the shaping of the dream began to take shape itself. The marriage and family program, then based in the School of Theology but partly off campus, was originally founded and directed by Robert Bauer. It languished after Dr. Bauer's death, however, in 1978. Dr. Dennis Guernsey, a well-known marriage and family counselor, was then recruited to fill this position. He brought the program fully onto campus, secured initial accreditation from the American Association for Marriage and Family Therapists in 1984, and started the doctoral program. Dr. Guernsey further recruited three faculty who would go on to become crucial to putting the program on the map: Jack and Judy Balswick in 1982, and the first PhD graduate from the new program in 1986, Cameron Lee. Dr. Guernsey was also successful in obtaining a Pew Foundation grant to found the Marriage and Family Institute. In 1987, after considerable discussion between Dr. Hart, Dr. Robert Mai, then Dean of Theology, and Dr. Guernsey, it was agreed to transfer the Marriage and Family program to the School of Psychology, where Dr. Guernsey would become its first director and the associate dean for the newly formed Marriage and Family Division. Thus was added a more complete dream for meeting the mental health, emotional, and relational needs of the church. Dr. Guernsey then accepted a position at Seattle Pacific University, and Dr. Thomas Needham, then the director of the Marriage and Family Program at Azusa Pacific University, was recruited as the second director and associate dean of the Marriage and Family Division. Under Dr. Needham's leadership, all degree programs in Marriage and Family were revised and specifically related to family therapy. The student body was expanded, the doctoral programs enlarged from 5 to 60 students, and AAMFT accreditation strengthened and secured for the future. Dr. Needham also spearheaded the extension of the program in Northern California, having added 3 full-time and 2 part-time faculty. But change was once again in the wind. In 1993, Dean Hart announced his intention to step down after 12 years of service as dean. Following a nationwide search, the committee directed its call to a son of the program, James Guy had graduated in clinical psychology from Fuller in 1981 and was distinguishing himself as a university vice president at Biola University. His leadership was just what was being sought for the next phase of the school's development.
And Jim, we believe you are God's chosen leader for the next part of our journey. You come from our past, understand our commitment to placing the cross in the heart of the healing professions, and know what it will take to lead us into the next century. As you pick up where others have faithfully sown in both psychology and marriage and family, I want to assure you of our prayers, our wholehearted support, and our commitment to help you succeed.
The graduate school that started as an experiment in the face of much skepticism has now become a reality. It has spawned many clones as others have captured the dream. And now, with more than 1,200 graduates from both divisions scattered all around the nation and beyond, we need a renewed vision for the healing work of the gospel in the hearts and minds of individuals and their families.